In other news now, the social media influencer responsible for a podcast which made disparaging remarks about a South Auckland girls' school earlier this month has since apologised to the school. Sydney sider Jordan Simi made the comments in his Grouse and a Few Reds podcast, where he took a dig at New Zealand women before making a link to the school. However, this week, Simi, a Samoan who grew up in South Auckland, walked back on his views after a torrent of online criticism, some which accused him of being a racist.
Well, joining me today to discuss that podcast in our Talanoa are two proud, I want to say proud, former students of Macaulay High School in South Auckland. They're Auckland City Councillor Josephine Bartley and journalist Salah Jane Aholele Hopgood. Thank you both for joining us on the show.
Thank you for having us.
Yes, thank you.
First of all, when you saw that podcast and what was going through your mind when you saw his comments? Josephine.
Well, I actually got tagged in it by my sister, my BFF sister, Jacinta Whalilifiro.
Ex-Macaulay, yeah.
Ex-Macaulay as well, extremely proud. And I didn't want to watch it. I just didn't want to see it. But I looked at it, I read it. I read Salah Jane's article. And yeah, just disappointing, I think, was my initial reaction.
Salah Jane, you wrote the article, which also a lot of people responded to as well. What was going through your mind was a lot of memories growing up and hearing taunts, you were saying.
Yeah, definitely. I was just like simply tired of hearing the comments. This is me having graduated over 10 years ago and having firsthand had those comments said to me and behind my back. And not just me, but every other Macaulayan that had gone through the school. And so to then hear it, it's 2022, and to hear the comments said again on a podcast with a large following across the ditch, it's just like, really? Like, I couldn't believe it. So I did, as a journalist, I was like, I'm going to pitch this story idea to my editor. And just as I was writing notes on my phone or what points I should raise, my editor actually messaged me on the Sunday and she was like, hey, Salah, I know you went to the school. I'm happy to support you in this story. So shout out to the spin-off for supporting me all week, the editorial team especially, because that's what I needed. I just needed that bit of confidence to push me over the line to then get that story, to get our lived experiences heard and understood by the masses, seeing his audience had already had a view of us that was not true.
And he's apologised. What did you think of the apology, Josephine?
Well, I thought it was interesting because he talks about his show being about mental health and about uplifting, yet those comments were nowhere near uplifting. And, you know, as Pacific women, as, you know, our young Samoan girls that were watching, our young Pacific girls that were watching that, our students at Macaulay, growing up in South Auckland, that's the last thing you need is one of your own putting you down on that kind of platform. And I just think, you know, for Jordan, he's got a platform, use it responsibly, because you're not just there representing your own mouth, you're representing your family, you're representing where you come from, and you know, people look to him. So please use your platform responsibly and use it for good. Use it for what he says it's for, which is the, you know, mental health and uplifting others.
You know, as a Pacific woman, and we're talking about a lot of, you know, Macaulay girls who are watching this, tell us about that in terms of stereotypes about Pacific women, even how some of our men view us.
Yeah, it's having gone through Macaulay, we were definitely seen as the undesirable all-girls school to I'm going to say it out loud because it's true. Like, compared to other all-girls school here in Auckland, we were probably seen as a less desirable version you got to look at the facts. Like, we're an all-brown school. Is that the reason why boys won't like us or see us a certain way? Like, we have to have these discussions to then stamp out the stereotypes that are placed on us. And I think now, although this podcast has been said and didn't really do us any justice, we had to take the positives out of it, which was that it really did give a chance for Macaulay to be like, okay, yeah, we've made our mark when it comes to academics, when it comes to Polyfest and sport, but, like, you know, for those who aren't aware, here's our school and this is what we're proud of.
And hasn't struggled with success in terms of
excellence
achievement. Last night, all the girls were yesterday, all the girls were celebrating with achievement. The whole school was there to celebrate that. And you guys are just testament to that as well. So many girls are coming out of Macaulay as well, of South Auckland too.
Yeah, And you know, we are, you know, Macaulay is more than just the school, it's our community. Yeah. And Macaulay is with you for life. You know, De La Salle, they're hardcore as well about, you know, La Salle for life as well, our brother school. But even they were coming out supporting Macaulay. And, you know, there's all these jokes, oh, don't marry a La Salle, but they end up getting married anyway. But yeah, we're extremely proud of our school and our roots and where we come from. And everybody that, you know, and even in my year, they've all done so well in whatever fields they've chosen. And especially motherhood as well. You know, we had some girls that was their goal was to be good mothers, and they are really good mums.
Well, I know the Talano will definitely continue. Chat online with us. We'd love to still hear your thoughts. Thank you both for coming on the show.